What's up, guys? Welcome back to Culprit Muscle TV here. Getting ready to do a four-room clean. Not in terrible shape at all. It is hot. It's about 95 outside. When you first get here, the AC is not running, so you turn it on and you sweat right until you're about done. And then it starts getting cool. But at least the carpet gets to dry nice when you turn the AC on. So let me show you what I'm gonna do. Nothing really overly fancy here. It's not overly dirty. But I am going to add at least one extra step with a white pad. So let me show you everything I've got here to work with. And again, what I'm going to be doing this with here. So I'll be right back. Hang on. All right. First, let's look. This is the living area, largest area. And I think it's got probably the most traffic. And the most traffic is going to be right around in here. And through here, and then in the master, you can see the traffic pattern. You see it more when you're vacuuming. So the traffic pattern is right through here, and then it turns and it goes right in that door right there. You can kind of tell that when you're vacuuming, how the carpet reacts to the vacuum. You know, where you don't have traffic, you know, the fibers, they move really easy under the vacuum, and where you do have traffic, they don't. So I'm going to spray both areas down fairly well, and then the traffic areas are going to get a pre-scrub. I might just pre-scrub everything basically, but I'm going to pre-scrub everything with the white pad. I've got three of these basically these microfiber polishing pads here. A gentleman asked me the other day on Messenger about these guys. He was asking me, he found some for like $13.99 or something like that. Asked me if they were worth it. And you know, I paid $3.99 for these back when IKEA still had them. I bought them over a year ago and they're holding together just fine. I even took them on that one job where I used them on basically it was kind of gravel over concrete. And it lived through that just fine. So these guys have got over a year on them. And a few of them, the edges will start coming off here, but they still work just fine. So this is a side that grabs the machine here. You can see it, you know, it shows a little bit of wear here because it's where the Velcro grips it. And then the side that goes on the carpet, you know, it's showing some wear, but it's still got plenty of life left in it. So, you know, at $13 a piece, it's no big deal. I would, you know, it'd be hard for me to pay 13 bucks a piece for them because I paid so little for them, but they're definitely worth up to about $20 a piece considering how well they work and how long they last. I wish these guys would last longer. This is the ultimate pre-scrub right here. You get the scrubbing along with the orbital action on the scrubbing. So it basically sets up the carpet for the perfect extraction when you come behind them with these guys here. Basically polish all the soil out of the fibers. And these little fingers are what grab the soil and pull it out of there a little deeper than you would with a flat towel. So anyway, I'm gonna pre-spray all this down. Now, and as far as what I'm using here, since it's not incredibly soiled, I'm using, this is peroxide and the my own personal blend of plant-based detergent, which basically what's in this jug is two capfuls of the plant-based Tide and one capful of the OxiClean White Revive, and then the rest is water. And then you'll add, you know, I tend to add a little more because I can. It's so cheap. I can make a jug for about a dollar. So I add about this much to each one of my sprayers. And then I'll add this much, probably about this much peroxide to it. And then lately what I've been doing on all of them is, depending on how dirty it is, I'll add a little bit of this in there too, just to boost the pre-spray and make it stronger. I'm getting all of that. It's all soaking in here. In here, I've only got the plant-based Tide basically in there. So that's what we're gonna use here. And I'm using less chemical in this job than I do on jobs that are extremely soiled. You know, you gotta change the way you do things when things are extremely soiled, and you change the amount of times you go over it. You know, I would run probably the blue pad over it first and then finish with that pad if it was extremely soiled. It's not. So anyway, I'm going to first spray this room here, and I'm gonna come back and I'm gonna run the white pad over it, and then I'm gonna run the other white polishing pad over it, and we're gonna shine this carpet up real pretty. So I'm gonna show the whole cleaning process, at least in this room, maybe in the room to the right here too. All right, ready to polish this carpet up here. I'm gonna do pre-scrub the white pad first here. Here we go. pad pulls out better than the red pad does, and it moves easier through the carpet. So now we're gonna get ready to shine it up here. Sweaty, sweaty. All right, what I'm gonna do here is kind of change the camera angle. We can see everything I want to do on the right side of the room here now. Whenever you go over the light pad, you dislodge the soil, so it makes going over it the second time a lot faster. The soil moves faster when you've loosened it like that. And it's being held in the suspension, basically. The white pad that scrubs doesn't truly remove the soil. It just sets it up for the removal. Now we're going to groom it. Somebody asked me to show more grooming, so that's quite a bit of grooming right there. It's a shame that fan doesn't turn. So I'm gonna do this guy here and we will take a look when I get finished. The main area to watch is basically right what I said, but you come through the door and go that way. That's the main traffic area. So I will return. All right, I did a pre-scrub in here with a white pad, as you can see. Earlier, I want to show you what I got out. It didn't look like it had that much soil in it, but that's what I got out of this room out here. So let's see what I can get out of this room here. And I'll kind of show, you know, you can see the pre-scrub in it. So everything's ready to come out. I've already done the two closets in there. So now we're going to run this through the fibers. And I'm going to kind of show how fast I go. Hold it in one hand and record with the other. drive with one hand. All right, I'm gonna groom this and we'll take a quick look at it. Quick look back here. All right. Let's go see how much soil I took out. You can see where the bed was at. Now, there was a lot less soil. This was the living room, and that was the bedroom I just finished there, so. More soil in the living room than there was in the bedroom. These other two rooms we're gonna do, I'm gonna use the same towel on both of those guys, because they don't have near the soil in them. This one here doesn't appear to have any real issues at all. This one here, it's got a little something going on right in the middle of the room. I don't know what it is, but it should come out okay. I'm just gonna get a shot of the super strong right on that area there. Anyway, I'm gonna pre-spray both of these, clean them, and we'll come back and take a look. I don't want the video to be too terribly long. So I'm gonna clean them and I'll be right back. All right, finished up these last two rooms. Got the red pad back under the machine. This pad that stays under it so I don't destroy my my Velcro on the machine. Get a lot longer life out of it that way. Here we go. This is the room that had a little thing in the middle of it. That's gone. Turned out good. All right, let me try this again. Since I got started, the phone rang. A guy just called wanting to know if I could repair his carpet today. And he called me right back again because he found me listed again. He goes, man, you've got such good reviews. You're just popping up everywhere. All right, well, I tried pretty hard. Anyway, this guy's all done here. Something was going on over there. I don't know if this was like an office or something. It's got funny wear on that particular part of the carpet. Best I could figure it'd probably be maybe a desk or something set up over there. Anyway, we're back to good now. I even did a special thing for the realtor. There was a bird's nest up there and had bird poo all out here. She asked me to clean that up for her, so I did. I brought a water hose with me and sprayed it down with peroxide and made it get all bubbly and then blasted it right out of there and everything came out really well. It's one of those things you don't know what to charge for because that's the service that you offer. You just try to help people when you can. All right, well done out here. And this room is the only one that's got the fan on. So I took my AC and adjusted it back up to about 71 there. I had it at about 65. I've only got it down to 77 in here, but it's a whole lot drier than it was. All right, guys. I'm in Leander now, which is right outside of Austin. You always hear me say I'm right outside of Austin. I've got some tile. I don't know how much tile it is. I got some tile to do, and I've got a couch to do for a existing client out there. So I'll cover one of the two. I really don't enjoy covering upholstery, so it probably won't be that. It'll probably be the tile. At any rate, I appreciate you guys watching. Leave your comments, any questions. And if you have specific questions, it's always, you're okay, you're welcome to text, but I generally don't enjoy getting phone calls because phone calls are generally somebody trying to sell me something. 512-350-1129. Thanks for watching, guys.